Uniwix has launched a new wig. Uniwix has launched a new medium length, brown, beautiful new human hair wig, and I'm here for it. So this brand new wig on the Uniwix site is called Serena. It's a lace top Remy human hair wig, and it retails for $779.89. And the color is cold coffee brown. This wig has a luxurious Remy human hair, so it's made from premium Remy human hair. The hair is long lasting and can be freely heat styled with curlers, flat irons, blow dryers. I'm gonna show you guys how I do that. It's a brunette balayage color, and it has temple to temple front lace. So this offers a natural hairline and a free parting to part the hair in the middle or the side of your choice. So I know that some of you guys are beginner wig people and you really want to get into the world of wigs, but it really kind of freaks you out to buy a wig and to spend so much money not really knowing what you're getting yourself into. So the one thing that I want to tell you is that when you first get a wig, Uniwigs are amazing quality. They have beautiful quality hair. I have three different Uniwigs. I wear them all the time. I style them differently a lot, and they really hold up great with heat styling. They look fantastic. They look super natural. But when you first get it, it does look wiggy, and it's not because of Uniwigs. It's because it is a wig, and it's not styled or customized to your exact look. So I'm gonna put this on. The lace hasn't been cut yet. I'll show you how to do that in a second, but I'm gonna show you what the wig looks like before doing any customizations at all, because I think a lot of people get this wig fear, but really the fear is unwarranted, because when you spend like 10 minutes working on it, you end up getting something that's amazing. So take a look at what this wig looks like before I do anything right from the box. Okay, so as you can see, there are a few things that need to be done. We definitely need to style it, because this really bouncy kind of roller curl style of curl isn't really my thing. And I feel like we could open up the parting. A dead giveaway that a wig is a wig is when this part is too narrow and small, because your natural hair parts in a much deeper way. So a way to get around doing that is just plucking the hairline. I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. Now the first thing that you're gonna do is you are going to grab some scissors and you are going to cut that lace around the hairline. And you're going to go as close to those knots as you can without getting into the knots or without cutting the wig at all. So as you can see, there is all of that extra lace. The second step after you get any wig like this is you want to pluck that hairline and you want to open up this hairline a little bit more so that it looks a lot more natural. Now, you can just sit and do this on your lap for the sake of this video, because I want you guys to really see it. I'm going to bring out my mannequin head. I'm gonna do it on her. I'm also gonna style the hair on my mannequin head so I can style it like a stylist and put it on my head, which is one thing that I love about wigs. Sometimes I always wish that I could like get out of my head and do my hair, but with wigs you actually can. So I just pop it on a mannequin head that I shave. This is the creepiest mannequin head ever. She's the mannequin head that I use to dye and cut all my wigs. So she is like all dyed and shaved, and she looks super, super, super creepy, right? All right, so you can see her hairline right here. And all I'm going to do is open it up. So I'm gonna grab some of these hairs with my tweezers and I am going to pull them out to open up this whole area. We want to make this area more open and more clean so that it looks a lot more natural. Start with less and then add more, because you know you can't put it back on, but you can take it off. So you kind of want to start a little bit easy and then add more plucking if you feel like the hairline is still not looking totally natural. Once I've widened that part a little bit, I like to look at the front and see if there's any messy little hairs at the front, like all of this stuff. I do want to get rid of that, because that's going to sit in my face and it's going to make the wig look quite fake. So I'm just going to go ahead and clean up the front area so I don't have these weird hairs sitting right in front of my face. So you can see how neat this side is compared to the other side that I haven't done yet. See all this hair that's sitting here at the front? Taking a few minutes to do these small customizations really does make all the difference in the world. So don't skip this step. No matter what wig you get, it really, really does take your wig to the next level. Okay, so if you can see that, you can see that the part is much wider now and that all of these hairs here at the front have been cleaned up. So now it's gonna look a lot better on your head. It's gonna be a lot less messy and there's going to be a lot less hair kind of stringing down around your face, giving it away that it is not real. All right, so to straighten this wig, I'm gonna be using my Revlon flat iron. So I bought this flat iron months ago, probably over a year actually, on Amazon, and I did a whole review on it. I did like an unboxing and a first impressions review. I was very impressed with it. I will leave the link to that review up here in the cards and in the description box below. Something else that I want to caution you guys is using a heat protectant on your wigs so that you don't ruin them. So this one is Matrix. It's a heat buffer thermal styling spray. This is a great product because it has thermal protection up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. What I'm gonna do before I start, it's a mist. So I'm just gonna mist it all over the wig in preparation. You don't really have to do strand by strand or section by section, but I do like to lift the hair up so that I get those under layers as well. And it dries quite quickly, which is awesome. So as you can see, as I'm moving along this wig, when I put my flat iron through the hair, I am not getting any type of melt or any type of weird reaction to the heat. This is something that happens when your human hair wigs are not completely human hair. There is a huge issue in the hair extension and wigs world where they will claim that something is human hair, but it is clearly not. It is mixed with some type of fiber, some type of synthetic, and they will try to get away with saying that it's human hair and, you know, charging premium prices for it, but you can tell it's not because as you use high heat on it, certain parts of it will start to melt. You can also tell when hair isn't totally human hair because you will get these random fibrous strands that are like blue or red kind of sticking out of the wig. It's very, very frustrating when you pay a load of money and the quality of the hair is just bad. You can tell that this is human hair and that it is excellent quality because I am quite high up in heat. I am at 225 degrees Celsius and this hair is not sizzling, it's not burning, nothing is happening other than the fact that the hair is straightening and it's super glossy, super smooth, and super, super shiny. Look at that. This is gorgeous hair. This quality is amazing. So as you can see, it is an angled kind of long bob. It's a little bit longer than a long bob, but it is angled forward. So it gets longer as we move forward. This was a hairstyle that was super, super in style this year. I cut a lot of it. So it's pretty cool that they brought this into a wig. It makes sense because it really is very, very in style. Let's go check it out in different lighting. All right, you guys, so I'm not even gonna glue this down because I know a lot of you guys don't like to glue your wigs down. I typically do with Got To Be spray, but I know that's kind of a hassle for people. So I'm showing you what it looks like without gluing it down at all. And it is quite seamless. It looks pretty darn natural. That's without even painting the hairline. Sometimes you can also paint the hairline with foundation. It is beautiful. It is a beautiful wig, very, very natural. This is what it looks like in natural lighting. So I am now outside. All right, so hopefully that was helpful in showing you guys how this hair looks when it is straight in different types of lighting. So now I wanna show you what it looks like when it's waved. I'm gonna use my T3 iron, and this is a 1¼-inch iron. Okay, so this is definitely my favorite way to wear it. I just love texture in hair. This gives you just enough texture that it looks really, really sexy and has tons of movement, but not so much texture that it looks like you're going to a special event. I'm gonna go put on some neutral lips. I'm gonna put on some nude kind of glossy lips so that you get a different vibe of this hair as well, okay? I'll be right back. And there you go, that's what it looks like with a little bit of wave and with a neutral lip. Now it's a little bit less fussy, a little bit more daytime. Which look do you guys like more? Do you like look one, straight with red, or look two, wavy with nude? Let me know in the comment section. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Thank you so much for watching. If you got this far, then don't forget to subscribe down below. I will see you in a few days. Bye.